Yes, I think so too. We've been concerned, of course, about the new counseling that has entered into the equation just recently. And, you know, I made some notes when Linda was talking about the health clinics are not officially Common Core. However, they will have access to the testing, the non-academic testing, and could be determined at risk by the counseling officials there.
Well, my concern is that would be done. I'm not saying it has been done, connecting up at that level, but when you bring a mental health facility or provider into a school and you're also doing that type of testing, you've got to see what kind of referral system you have for that. I mean, you're just crossing a dangerous line to even bring mental health therapy into a public school as part of the school. That is just a dangerous line to cross. And I don't think we should be doing that. You know, I listed a number of reasons, but I think very logically people can go through that and say, you know, I really don't want my child in that system because this is nobody's business. You know, things that used to be nobody's business are now being recorded and put into data file, and we need to be very aware of that.
Now, since it's not in the Common Core system, what system authorizes mental health counseling within the schools?
Well, I think in that article it says, I think it's the State Department of Health is one of the agencies that brought this in. Now, when you look at the Dear Hillary letter from Mark Tucker to Hillary Clinton, Mark Tucker outlines a lot of different things involved in their big, big plan. You know, we're talking about numerous state agencies and federal agencies all collaboratively working together to produce, a better, healthier child, a child that is, you know, has the right dietary needs met, health needs, educational, including what they call the whole child, looking at psychological as well as academic areas, and there are people who truly, many people, I should say, there are many people who just think of this intellectually and don't think about the reality of privacy, of the subjectivity. Let's talk about that. A lot of these things that we're talking about are very subjective. In other words, it depends on the opinion of that person as to how something is rated or evaluated, tagged or labeled. When you're into a subjective area like that, that's very dangerous because it gives people power over a child's life. To have a file that has a label in it. I taught special ed, and that was one of our biggest areas of concern, of caution, of continual work and debate, that we not do more harm to a child than good when they come in and we're labeling and we're putting things in their file that will be seen by other people. You just have to be very aware that this isn't like producing widgets on a conveyor belt. We're talking about people's lives.
So much information, Ms. Barbara, and not, you know, we will have Ms. Linda Murphy back on, thank God. But I also want to mention this because you were talking about, you know, the people behind it. And as you, you know, mentioned to us, well, you know, it's ACHIEVE, it's the College Board and ACT that were there, you know, forming this Common Core. And when we look at David Coleman's mindset with a new AP U.S. history, everybody needs to heed that warning. That is the behind the AP U.S. history. How un-American, unpatriotic that is.
Right.
So I think we need to make a stand. And-